Hi, in this video of Form Title in Salesforce, I will show you how to determine if an email address entered by the user belongs to a contact or a lead in Salesforce. To do that, I'm capturing the email address, I'll display some information about the lead or contact, I will display to the user if they are a lead or a contact, there are two labels here, and obviously we will save the lead ID or contact ID. To display the relevant label, we have conditions set on the lead ID and contact ID to say if it's not empty, I want you to show the lead label or the contact label. That's how simple it is to show the relevant labels. Now the interesting bit is, how do you find if they are a contact or a lead? To do that, we go to Salesforce, map fields, and we will add an object. We will select the contact object, and we'll say bring me a contact object by email. So email in Salesforce equals to the email address the user has entered. Okay, that's simple. Now all we have to do is bring the data from Salesforce. So we'll go to map fields and we'll say bring me the first name, the last name, source to source, and contact ID to contact ID. That's nice and easy. Click apply. Now we need to do the same thing for lead. But for lead, we don't want it to run automatically when the email address changes. We want it to run only when we want it to run. So I'm setting custom button. Condition stays the same. So this time it's email equals email again. Click apply. And then, as usual, we've got to map our fields. So again, we will map first name, last name, source, and this time lead ID. Click apply and apply again. Now we want to go back to the contact and say to the contact, look, when you have not found a contact, go and try and find a lead. That's how easy it is to say, is it a contact or is it a lead? I'll click apply and that's all done. Now the next step is obviously update the data when the user clicks submit. To do that, I'll go to push to Salesforce. I will add the contact object. Select contact. The action will be update, and we find the contact to update by contact ID because we have saved it in the hidden field. So we can do that. And then we can say only do this update if the contact ID is not empty, because there's no point doing it if we didn't find a contact. And then which field we want to update, I will switch to form fields. And then we can say update the first name, update the last name, and update the source. Click apply and apply again. Now we do the same thing for contact, for lead. Here we will select lead. Again, the action is update. How are we updating? By lead ID this time. And we will set a rule again, do not update if the lead ID, if the lead ID is empty. So lead ID has got to be not empty. Click apply, and then we want to map our fields as usual. We've got first name, we've got last name, and we've got source. That's all we have to do to determine if they are a lead or a contact and update them. Let's see it in action. I'll click publish. I'll click view. Here is a contact I have in my Salesforce. We can see that we have found that it's a contact. I'll update the full name, for example, and I change the source. And when I click submit, and I go back to the form, you can see that it's been updated. As simple as that. I'll just revert my update. And then let's check a lead. So it is a lead I have in my database. And you can see it's found it's a lead. Put the full name. I'll change the full name. I'll change the source. And when we come back, you can see that lead now is being updated. As simple as that. Thank you very much, and I hope that showed you how easy it is to use Form Title.